Hey, what's up? Matthew Parsons. The concept of something better is something that we are moving towards. Is there something better for my life? And I'm pulling into the gym today, and it is Thursday, and the parking lot is about 50% of what it was on Monday. And it always makes me laugh. Tomorrow, Friday, forget about it. Friday is like ghost town. Right? But this is the way that it goes. If you've ever been a part of a gym, you know, January, it is packed and people are on fire. Mondays, it is packed and people are on fire. I'm going to have this life change. It's going to happen and it's going to start, and it's on a Monday. It's a new fresh start. It's in January. It's a new fresh start. And then February rolls around and half the people are there. And then March rolls around and half of those people are there. Now, I'm not making fun of anybody, because the fact is 90% of the time in my life, I've been that person that opts out by March. I'm the person who's done by Wednesday. I'm sick and tired of waking up early. I'm sick and tired of all that kind of stuff, and I give up. But what I've discovered is in my desire to have something better in my life, what I'm starting to do is reverse engineer it. And I'm going, what is it that I want? Instead of going, hey, how am I going to get? I go, what is it that I want? And then I just start diving into that, okay? This is what I want. Okay, then I develop the plan. This is how I'm going to get there. Now, what I've discovered is that as I'm creating that plan, is the plan that I'm putting together is never going to work, right? Mike Tyson's classic line, you know, everybody's got a plan going in until you get punched in the face. And what happens is 99 times out of 100, right? Monday, you're on fire to hit the gym. Tuesday, you know, you get punched in the face and you're like, I'm going to keep going. And then Wednesday, you get punched in the face again and everything falls apart. And so we give up. In my business, right? I've got this plan. This is what I'm going to do. It's going to be awesome. People are going to start coming to me because I'm the man, or the woman, if it's, you know, if you're a female. And then what happens is it doesn't work. And so we quit. We go, oh, this isn't working. I'm going to go try something else. When in reality, not quitting is the best thing that we can do, and instead we want to tweak. It's a perfect example here. When it comes to my body, when it comes to physically and trying to get in shape, I know what I want. And so I start moving towards it, right? But the problem is I've got this plan in my head, but the plan is just, it's crap. And rather than give up on the plan, I start tweaking it. So for me, things that were sabotaging, roadblocks that were in my way, ended up being things like I hated waking up early and going right and waking up, working out. Okay. All right. So what can I do first to prime my body, get my joints moving, all this kind of stuff, so that I don't hurt when I'm working out? Then I started realizing, you know, I don't have any, like, I do this and then my nutrition's terrible throughout the day, or I don't even eat, and I got to be fueling my body. And I found out, hey, you know what? I should take a meal with me. Well, then what is that? So I started doing meal prep the week before. Do meal prep. Then I got my things. They're in the fridge. And I just grab them and I go. Then I found out, you know what? I'm getting there. I'm working out, and then I'm driving home, which is a pain in the butt. And then I'm showering, and then I'm changing, and then I'm going. No, like, this is close to my office. So you know what I do now is I go ahead and I pack a bag, and I've got my clothes and they're ready to go. Then not only that, but I was taking my packed bag and I was putting it by the front door. And then what I found was I've got my packed bag with my gym clothes, and then I've got a carrier for my dress clothes, and then I've got a bag for my computer, and then I'm carrying around a gallon jug of water, because again, I had tweaked things. I kept finding out that I wanted to drink water and I was running out, so I needed a gallon, and I carry it around with me, and it's in my car now. So I tweak and I tweak and I tweak. Found out that putting all these bags by the front door was a bad idea, because it's 6 a.m. in the morning and I've got all this stuff and I'm trying to carry it out to my car, and it's a disaster. So you know what? Now I tweaked and I put it into the car the night before. I added 40 extra steps. That's it. Says send it by the front door. I tweak, and it's made such a huge difference. Now I wake up, boom, my smoothie's pre-made, because again, I didn't want to wake up the family, found out that it wasn't working, that I wasn't going to get my smoothie, so I go ahead and I get it and I do it the night before. Now I've got it, boom, open up the fridge, walk out the door, my stuff's in the car, and I go. So the question is where have you given up when a simple tweak would have taken that roadblock and taken that hurdle? Now, the last thing I'll encourage you to do is this, is you have to review. You have to go, why did I fail? Where did I go wrong? This is what you have to do. You have to go, where did I go wrong? Now, you answer the question, well, wait, would a simple tweak, is there something that I could do beforehand or change in my behavior or my timing or something like that that would make a difference? Or should I quit? I think you'll find that 9 times out of 10, a simple tweak is the answer. Don't quit, tweak. I'm Matthew Parsons. I want to encourage you to strive for something better in your life, and that can start by reviewing and tweaking. Thanks. God bless.